Hello and welcome to lesson 9. In this lesson, I'm going to be talking about fasting. You see, when you pray concerning your problem and you pray and you pray and you pray and it seems as if the problem remains and there is no answer to that problem, then you need to try to fast. Fasting is abstaining from food, abstaining from sometimes drinking, abstaining from maybe sex. You abstain from things that give you pleasure. Sometimes you abstain from going to some areas where you do have fun. You abstain from things that your body normally love to have. So you abstain from those things just to separate yourself and to say, this problem in my life, I don't want it. I want it out of my life. And so I'm dedicating the following number of days to fast and to pray to God, so that my problem can go away. Fasting is very good. It's a spiritual exercise that helps everybody. There is no great man of God that you see around you that does not fast. Fasting helps us to develop in our spiritual life. And fasting is abstaining from food. When you want to fast, you can fast for 1 day, you can fast for 3 days, you can fast for 7 days or 5 days, you can even fast for 21 days. When you fast, you don't eat. Sometimes when you want to fast for long, maybe 7 days or 21 days, you may need to be drinking water. You see, absolute fast is that fasting that you fast, you don't eat, you don't drink. But when it is more than 3 days, you are advised to now begin to drink water. You drink water just for your body, you know, for your body chemistry to keep going. So you need the water. If you are going to fast beyond 3 days, so you drink the water, that is full or complete fast. There are some fasting you fast in the evening, maybe 6 o'clock, you break by eating something and drinking something. Maybe you want to do that for 30 days or 40 days. Every evening, maybe 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock, you eat and you refresh yourself, then you continue the fasting the following day. You know, there are some fasting you break by 12 o'clock in the noon. You see, you can also start your fasting by 12 o'clock in the afternoon and end it the following day. You see, anyhow you want to do, but what you are doing in the fasting is that you are abstaining from things that gives you pleasure in order to look into the spiritual realm for solution to your problem. And when you fast, take time to pray. When you fast and you are not eating and you don't pray, it will not really help you. You need to pray, and most of the time, study the word of God. You fast, you pray, you study the word of God. In the time when you are fasting, most of the time, the Spirit of God will speak to you. God will begin to show you the solution, how to get out of that problem. Because this is a spiritual exercise. It works. When prayer alone does not work for you, put fasting with it. When you fast and you pray, certainly your problem will go away. Many things cannot go without fasting. In fact, in the book of Mark chapter 9, Jesus was telling the disciples, when they could not solve a problem by casting out the devil, they said, our Father, our Lord, why could we not do it? He said to them, this kind cannot go out but by fasting and prayer. You need to fast for some problems to go away. Some problems will never go out of your life until you fast. Fasting is very important. You should try it. It does not kill. In fact, fasting helps the body. You see, scientifically and medically, when you abstain from food for some time, it helps your body. Fasting is good, is healthy, and it helps you. Try it. Your problem will go away. Thank you for listening. I will see you in lesson 10.